Hello everyone, I'm back again after a roughly 1 month break in which I couldn't record any movies, and I'm gonna do once again a let's play on Rise and Fall of Civilizations in Abundance, and this time, just as I promised, it will be the Native Americans. Where are they? Here they are. The Native Americans and Sitting Bull. They've got a unique unit. Dog Soldier replaces X-Men. He's got less strength, but he's got 100% against other melee units. So it's a really good unit to fight against other early melee units. However, it's not very suitable for anything else. Unique building totem pole against monument. I don't remember exactly what's the difference. I can check that. And unique power, the power of the warrior culture. Melee units get shock and drill as a free promotions. Not really useful, as you will see for this game. Historical victory goals. Secure 3 corn resources by 1100 AD. That's kind of difficult. But once you know what to do, once you figure out the steps where to settle and in which order to build and slave rush everything, you should be fine. It's 1100 AD, but as you can see, they start in 900 AD, so it's only like 40 turns to do it. So that's relatively difficult. Well, you will see. Don't allow any Spanish colonies in North America in 500 AD. That's also not very easy. And don't allow any colonies in North America in 750 AD. Usually when you complete the first goal, the second goal, the third one you should complete as well. The main problem with these goals is that you need a little luck to don't get the conquistadors when meeting new nations. I can show you some tricks how to do it. Hopefully I will be able to not get any enemy on my territory. I'm gonna go for Viceroy as usual, and this is a 3000 AD start, so it will be a while before it loads. I'm gonna skip that. But I'm just gonna take a moment to explain why I haven't recorded any movies, because I've got plenty of commentaries asking that, and it's because of my job that I had in a different city where I was living without access to internet. So that was really, really boring, but that's behind me now, and hopefully in the next month I will be able to record and load some movies. Okay, so that's it. I've got like 200 turns to go, but I'm gonna skip that. Let's see you in a couple of minutes. And I'm back. The auto turns have ended, so let's start. I got three jaguars. Awesome. One of them moves here, and here's the corn resource. One of the resources which I need to have. Here's another corn resource, and one more is here somewhere in the at the top. So now I'm gonna move one of my settlers here so that I can get access to both of these resources with my first city. Okay, let's settle. I can get a totem pole, for example, to speed up the culture, which I will probably go for. I want to switch definitely to slavery and to heredity rule as well with one turn. The second settler moves to the north, and somewhere here is another resource, but let's check for any barbarians so that they don't kill my settler, because that would be really, really bad. Okay, I'm gonna send one the Jaguar for scouting purposes, and the other one I will control manually. Now, the text. There's really not much that you can and need to research, because you won't be able to catch up to the European nations anyway. Probably the most useful technology is feudalism, so that you can build longbowmen to defend your cities. Optics would also be a choice to build caravels, but you're not gonna get to caravels before the Europeans, as you could do with Mayans. So I'm gonna go for feudalism first. It also leads to civil service, which is a really good the bureaucracy which you get from civil service. So let's go for this first, and that's it for this turn. Okay, you can fortify in the city, you can fortify as well, and you go. Yeah, you settle here so that I can chop down that forest for production speed up. And you're gonna go for worker. Can I speed up the worker? No, not yet. I should get three more workers. Yeah, I got one free worker. So this one goes here. You fortify, you guys fortify, you go scout a little, but you will also return to the city. I can speed up the totem pole, then I will go for another worker. Because you need boat, farm and a road. Get this goal, and you need to build them SAP. That's the thing you need to do first in the game. My borders expanded, so I'm already in the range of the third resource, but I haven't completed the goal because I need the roads and of course the farms. Here are the Mayans. What can we do? We can trade open borders. Well, okay, the Mayans have probably gathered all the goody huts which were around. I don't see the one over here. The one over here is probably also gone. I wouldn't worry too much about it. Okay, now I've got the worker, and I'm gonna go walls here and here, because there are a lot of barbarians running around, or at least there will be a lot of barbarians running around. So I should be, I need to be extra careful with that. Someone's built Hagia Sophia. Yeah, you give me a road. And you give me a farm. Okay, that's it for scouting purposes. And some barbarians already appear. A dog soldier. I think I've got some free barbarian attacks, so this one dog soldier here isn't dangerous at all. But if there are more of them, like here, that will be dangerous in a while. I'm gonna speed up the walls. Yes, that's right. And build a road to connect the crown to my capital. Although I don't think I need to do it. Yeah, I've already got two resources. The one here, that's probably because it's on the river. Anyway, I'm gonna build it I'm gonna build a road anyway. Okay, and now I need to start spreading my units on the coast of, on the east coast of America, so that if any European caravels or galleons, probably caravels, will show up, I get the chance to meet them before they can spot my borders. In which case, if they don't, if I meet them and they don't see my borders, I won't get the immediate war and the conquistadors. That is something I really would like to avoid. I've got the the combat, quick combat on for defensive purposes, so that you actually haven't seen the video of barbarians attacking me, but you can hear the noise that I am under attack. Okay, you got you. We got you here. You're gonna stay there, and another jaguar will stay somewhere here. I cannot build a galley because I don't have any cities on water, so galley is unfortunately not an option. And I don't want to build any cities that are at water, because then they would be easy to spot for the European nations. So I'm just gonna stick to my original plan. They are already angry, because they've already got 9 population. Okay, you've got road, as well. I should have 3 resources now. Yeah, I do have them. Will I get the goal, or do I need to wait for your 1,100 buy? So I should already have that. Theoretically. I think I will have to wait. Anyway, I'm gonna chop down the forests around my cities for the production, and also for so that my enemies don't have the bonuses in case I want to attack them. You fortify here. Yeah, now I got the goal completed. I'm gonna build a couple of archers, mostly in this city, so that it doesn't have the revolt isn't unhappy, thanks to the monarchy.